Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman would table her second budget on February 1st. Here is a look at some of the things that might change with this year's budget. The possibility of the change in the personal tax structure has always been keenly anticipated part of the budget. This year is going to be no different. First, the government, by all indications, is expected to change the tax-free slab from 2.5 lakh to 5 lakh rupees. Second, after the increase in the surcharge for the super rich, the effective tax rates went up to as high as 42.74%. The FM could consider lowering the tax burden on this category of taxpayers by reducing the surcharge to 25%. This would essentially mean that with a reduced tax burden, the common man will have more disposable income in their hand. This will help in boosting the consumption in the economy. In such a case, the government might do away with some of the exemptions under Section 80C and 87A that they provide to common man right now. The personal tax exemptions under various sections had cost government little over 97,000 crore rupees in 2018-19. Levying tax on long-term capital gains on listed securities and securities transaction tax amounts to double taxation. In this budget, the government might relook at this double taxation aspect. Currently, investments in the equity mutual fund schemes have held for more than a year qualify for a long-term capital gains tax of 10% on the gains exceeding rupees 1 lakh for financial year. Long-term capital gains tax was zero on the equity schemes earlier before the former finance minister Arun Jaitley decided to levy the tax rate of 10% in the 2018 budget. The government is also likely to extend the timeline of long-term capital gains on shares from current 12 months to 24 months. The government is considering a proposal to do away with the long-term capital gains on the selling of the property as well. The onus of paying the dividend distribution tax may shift to the receiver of the dividend. Right now, the giver of the dividend, as the companies, pay for the DDT. The effective tax rate currently stands at 17.65%. This will help India Inc. In improving their profit and loss account further. This comes after the benefits they have received under the cut in the corporate tax rates last year. Moving on to the sectoral allocations, there are three major sectors that we can watch out for in this year's budget: infrastructure, defense, and the social sector. Job creation has been at its lowest in 45 years, and so is the unemployment rate. The increased allocation towards the infrastructure sector will woo the foreign investors as well as create jobs in the economy in itself. The social sector allocation would have a multiplier effect on the consumption. And for example, an increase in the MNREGA allocation would lead to increase in the rural consumption, which would in turn lead to an increased stocking by the kirana stores and the wholesalers. Now the FMCG companies which would be supplying to these kirana stores and the wholesalers will also start producing more in this case. The modernization of the defense sector that government is aiming at right now needs at least 2.5% of the GDP. But the percentage of the capital outlay on the defense sector has been coming down in the past decade, much to the disappointment of the defense personnel. For all these allocations, the government needs to look at its revenue flow. The government's direct tax collection is set to contract for first time in past two decades. Any exemption in the direct tax is likely to hit the government's revenues. However, there is a catch. There is a 12 lakh crore tax arrear with over 17,000 crore of it pending for more than a decade. A lot of these arrears are stuck in the litigation process. If government comes up with a mechanism to address these woes on a priority, there would be a windfall of revenue for the government. There is a lot to look forward to this year's budget. Keep track of what matters to you with Deccan Herald's special coverage. For more, log on to deccanherald.com.